Here we come, walk down the street. We get the funniest looks from everyone we meet. Hey, hey, we're the monkeys, and people say we monkey around. But we're too busy singing to put anybody down.
And welcome to the Movie Dump Podcast,
where we ask questions in alphabetical order, such as, if you get really angry while playing Scrabble, do you suffer from irritable vowel syndrome?
So we started Month of Monkey this week.
We did. It's our first annual Month of Monkey, week one.
Yes. This week was Nick's pick.
Very bad time to do a Month of Monkey.
Yeah, we're kind of doing it.
Sort of in the middle of the month.
Yeah, we're in the middle of the month. Yeah. Oh, well, who fucking cares?
Yeah, you know. We work on Movie Dump time, which is 2 weeks, you know.
It's a week behind.
Yeah, everybody.
We don't dictate when the month actually starts.
Yeah, we don't go by the Christian calendar. We go by the Movie Dump calendar.
With you guys with no calendars, we're right on time.
Exactly. I can't wait to celebrate Knob Creek Day, where we all give presents to one another.
Would that be gifts of delicious Knob Creek?
Exactly.
Okay, then.
Hey, this year I'm asking for a monkey from the great moose god who delivers presents to us on Knob Creek Day.
Oh.
That's just a holiday I made up.
Very good.
I guess so. That's...
Yes.
Yeah, so...
So this week we watched...
Comes right after All Ruses Day.
Oh, the famous All Ruses Day.
Yes.
Everything's just a ruse.
Yep.
So we watched Shakma, which is a movie about a crazy ass baboon.
It's about a monkey.
Yes,
yeah. Monkey that goes crazy.
Exactly.
If you want to hear the official one,
What's the official synopsis or whatever?
I need some killer baboon music to be able to do this though.
I don't know if.
Where are we gonna find baboon?
Wait, music? here. Hold on. Here we go. I got something for you. Here you go.
Perfect. Okay, well, a murderous baboon escapes from a laboratory and roams the research building and begins to kill some teenagers who are also in the building playing a Dungeons and Dragons type game.
I don't know why I picked this music. I think it's just because a monkey sang it.
Maybe.
It really has nothing to do
with it. Well, it is Month of Monkey, where everything is involving monkeys and people eat bananas.
It didn't fit that at all. I'm sorry.
We should have really brought a monkey expert in on this, I think, but... I don't know any monkey
experts.
You're a monkey expert. Please email me so we can get you in on the rest of the month, the monkey.
Yeah. Sure.
Yeah.
So,
I have a synopsis for this.
Go ahead. Right. Yeah. Do your Nick synopsis.
It's the return of the Nick Brown synopsis. It's been so long since I've done one. This is monkeys fighting doors, pretty much, because there's a...
No, well, you kept saying it was a monkey shot out of a cannon.
Monkey shot out of
doors.
It's a monkey bazooka.
Yeah, it was a monkey bazooka.
Everybody in this movie, to get away from the monkey, they ran behind a door and closed the door and tried to hold the door shut. And the monkey went ape shit on that fucking door trying to get it open.
He went bananas.
Oh, yes.
There was no monkey business going on here.
No, there was no monkeying around on this one.
I ape to say it, but he really, really was berserk.
Oh, man. Wow.
That's right, three in a row.
How appealing.
Oh.
Good stretch.
Yeah.
But it worked. So you heard correctly. There was a Dungeons and Dragons game. They were LARPing inside a laboratory.
What is LARPing, Scott?
I don't fucking know.
I just love the reaction, Scott. He just like quickly turned at you, like, "Who the fuck are you to ask this question?"
Let me see if I can break down that since live action. Role playing.
What do people do in LARPing, Scott?
Well, if I was going through Shakma's,
they run from a monkey.
They get trapped in rooms from killer monkeys.
What a horrible game! This wasn't even a big monkey in this. It was a tiny little monkey.
Apparently, this monkey's just really, really pissed off because at the beginning of the movie, they're doing like surgery on his brain. They're like doing a biopsy or something. I don't know. They like they injected piss into the monkey's brain.
Well, seriously, yeah. It starts off. I think we have to do a lot of radio theater for this one because this is a movie that absolutely no one is going to see.
I'm going to throw up a lot. I'm going to throw a lot of the clips up on online.
Yeah. So the movie starts on a surgery table, and there's a professor kind of operating on a monkey and
testing out to see how high fructose corn syrup affects the
brain.
Was that the actual thing?
I don't know. That's that's just what it looked like to me, but I don't know.
He cuts open the monkey's head and cuts out a piece of it and injects like Vaseline into the monkey's brain.
Yeah, he injects some sort of yellowy liquid into the brain. So,
boy, does that piss the monkey off.
Yeah. Apparently, this monkey is healed from surgery quite fast and is now ready for payback.
Yep. Yeah, yep. He did. There was very little recovery time on this.
Which I was kind of confused because he reacted. There was a scene where they're all gathered in the lab, and the monkey reacted, but the monkey was still like tied down to the table.
He had a myoclonic jerk.
Yeah. So they knocked him out, and then the professor told them to cremate the body of the monkey. And then later on, when they're just about to cremate it, they're like, wait, no, keep it here.
Is there a soundbite of that bit?
I think there might be.
Well, let's find it.
Monkey bite!
What are you doing?
I thought you wanted me to cremate him.
Did I say that?
Yes, sir. Back in the lab.
I have to do a necropsy.
Whatever you say.
Yeah, you just leave him right there. Yeah, I'll come in and... What is today?
Friday.
Well, I'll come in tomorrow and I'll do it.
Oh, wow. All right,
so I can't believe that we actually said monkey bite both at the exact same time.
That was not planned whatsoever. I just want people to know that was not planned.
Yeah.
Oh, that was awesome.
I am eternally frightened.
We just shared a moment.
Oh, man. The rest of the month of monkey is like this. One of us will die.
We've both said soundbite before because that's just a given. I mean, we say soundbite before we play a soundbite. But monkey bite, that's right out of the gate there. Come on, that was great.
There was very little monkey in that monkey bite, actually. They were just discussing the thing.
No, they were discussing the monkey.
Let's do, what was it, some sort of autopsy or something on the monkey after it gets done, you know.
Yeah.
Makes sense, I guess. You just
But it's on a Friday, so like, just leave it sitting here on this slab until Monday.
Yeah, why did they? Why I don't know if I missed out. Why did they even decide to?
I guess because he wanted to do some research, try to figure out what happened. I don't know.
So they killed the monkey accidentally or something on the surgery.
Apparently, I don't
know. The monkey did not survive the surgery.
I think what happened was they injected him with something, and it caused him to go crazy. And then they tried to. Knock him out or something like that, and they injected him with the wrong stuff or something like that.
I don't
maybe.
Know.
Yeah, there was a scene like in here where I don't know, Flash Gordon was like getting like.
Was it Flash Gordon?
He looked like Flash Gordon.
No, it's Christopher Atkins.
He looked like
from Blue Lagoon.
Yeah, Flash Gordon. So Flash Gordon was like he was doing that whole. You know, in the medicine cabinet, and he was grabbing the medicine to put the monkey to sleep or something like that, or I don't know, something like that. And he grabbed, the wrong bottle of some medicine that was very closely labeled the same way as this, you know, go to sleep, but apparently it was the rage virus or something like that that he picked up, which, you know, on a tangent here, this laboratory, would not have passed OSHA standards, I don't think, because they had poisonous chemicals right next to the fucking bottles of you know, Aleve.
Well, not just that, they had hydrochloric acid just laying all willy nilly in the middle of a broom closet.
Like, what the fuck?
Okay. All right. There's no other chemicals around. There's just hydrochloric acid.
No standards for anything at all.
Yeah.
It was pretty bad, but
it was a 1990s lab. You know how people were back then.
Yeah, nobody gave a shit.
No,
it's like the fucking Joker was in there making some fear toxin or something.
Joker gas.
Yeah, Joker gas. And anyway, he grabbed the wrong I don't know, the non-poison. He grabbed the fucking crazy monkey poison. And
grabbed the batshit crazy serum.
Yeah, whatever, injected that into the monkey.
And the label was unpronounceable in the amount of time they gave you. You're like, oh no, don't grab the tire of
Fugaloscasterin. Oh no.
That would be awful.
How am I going to pronounce this? Nah, don't just grab it. Don't worry about it. Just grab it and inject it. So they inject the monkey with some bad juju. And the monkey, I don't know, goes fucking, like we said, monkey shit crazy.
He went fucking berserk. Like you would not believe.
But it wasn't a very terrifying monkey. He was like a, he was a very Scott. You said
very well groomed.
He was a very well groomed monkey.
I can't say that this monkey was terrifying at all, even when he was attacking people, because I had you fucking jackoffs over in the corner, like doing an audio track just the for monkey the monkey. Voice. Yeah, here, Nick. Just
give I don't know what this is.
Oh, you got yeah, you got you want banana.
That's all it is.
I think we're gonna have to do one
down the hallway. I'd just be sitting there yelling baboon.
Yeah.
I think we're gonna have to do an audio track for one of the videos that we put on YouTube.
Watch this movie, and if you just watch this movie and replay, and every time you see the monkey, just give him some line of dialogue. So he's just, "Hey, you guys, I like ice cream," and then he just runs down the fucking hallway and jettisons somebody. Himself on somebody's face. I'm gonna give you a kiss. And just make him fucking. Well, they did cut out part of his brain, so it was like the,
it could be.
They probably did talk like that.
They cut out the intelligent part of the monkey, I guess. And they just, yeah, he was freaking like just stupid monkey at that
exactly
point.
Exactly.
So you guys, I got loose again. I'm gonna murder you and stick you in an elevator.
But first, I'm gonna go and bang my head against this door for 5 minutes.
Stop!
Bang!
Hey, let me in the door. It was. He went like ape shit crazy on the door and just kept banging his head against the door to try and get it open.
I am surprised he didn't get himself a concussion every time he attacks somebody.
Yeah, we'll definitely have to post that one up on.
Yeah,
him just going fucking monkey nuts.
I have to say, I don't think this movie would have been able to be made nowadays because PETA would have had a field day with that one.
I suppose it was. It was no Congo, I guess.
No.
No
Congo. That's King for Kong remake.
That's PETA. For later on in the movie, or the month of monkey.
I think we're going to do that voice throughout every single monkey movie.
I think so, too. Just, it's
hi, I'm a banana and a jelly donut. Yay!
Would you like some of my poo?
I throw poo at everything because it tastes great.
All right, let's move it along.
Why, Ben? I don't know why we should do these things. I like banana-flavored ice cream.
So they're playing a D&D game in the laboratory. And there was like
group of well yeah we'll back it up a second
yeah,
radio let's... theater. So they're after they inject the monkey full of monkey steroids.
Oh wow, you're going way back up.
Yeah. And well yeah.
Because we haven't even gotten past that first scene yet.
They after they inject the monkey with monkey steroids and he goes fucking crazy and shit. They decide they're gonna just kill the monkey and embalm him, but they decide not to to hold off until Monday to do it because they want to play D&D in the lab.
Yeah.
Bad decision. Anyway.
Guys, we got to start playing the game.
Think of this like in like today's prison system or something, you know? They're like, oh, we got to fucking put down John Wayne Gacy, but you guys want to play Scrabble instead? You know?
But Scrabble, there all the pieces are hidden without the prison.
Yeah, that's weird. So yeah. They decide they're gonna play a game of D&D in this lab.
It was kind of an elaborate game of D&D.
It was
like,
live action role play.
Well,
here I have the explaining of the game. The guy that was creating the computer simulation for it and all that stuff. All right, here you go. Soundbite.
We can't talk to each other.
Why?
I set the frequencies. We can only talk to the game master.
Oh. Wow, you've really gone all out here, Bradley. Too bad you're gonna lose tonight.
Never happened before.
We've never played in a real building before.
Take a look at this. I designed the program to come up with the code words and clues, assign which classrooms are caverns, locations of the weapons, keys, reveal crystals, all that. And watch this. were right. The electronics lab had the tracking equipment we were looking for. Transmitter? Tracker.
Well, who's wearing that?
Tracy. I just slipped one in her pocket. I put trackers on every floor. So now, if all the Quest Knights have these, then the Game Master can monitor our progress through the tower. This is going to be our best game ever.
That should have been a monkey bite, actually, but there was no monkey in it. Anyway, that was a very half-assed explanation of the game, because it's funny, halfway, like, they didn't do a very... They explained what the game is, but they didn't really explain the rules or how this game is being played.
Yeah, so they really just explained that he put a sensor on everyone, and they have, like, the one-way walkie-talkie with the Game Master.
Yeah, they don't explain the rules or anything like that, so you don't know if a person's winning at the game or losing at the game, or if they're just fucking running, walking around, or what the hell it is.
It really seemed to me like the farther you along in the game, the higher up in the floors of the building you
were.
That's what it sort of seemed like to me.
Well, because the princess was in the tower, which is supposed to be the last floor.
And there was like a demon or something.
There's the nemesis.
414.
Nemesis Enforcer.
Who apparently, this is played by the character Richard, who somehow found out about the game through his sister and was like, oh, I heard about the game. I want to play the game. And then later on, he's like, oh, I don't know why I'm fucking here. I don't want to play this fucking stupid game. I'm going to get out of here. I'm like, well, why the fuck did you say you wanted to play the goddamn game?
Yeah, the jock guy, he decides he wants to play, and then he doesn't do shit throughout the entire thing. And he's, like, pissed off that he's there and annoyed.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, that really didn't make any sense to me. I couldn't figure out why he actually wanted...
I don't know. Because he was supposed to go on a date with his girlfriend.
Yeah.
But then he's like, you know what? Instead of getting pussy... I think I'm gonna play again. I'm gonna LARP.
With extremely effeminate D&D guys.
You gotta be a hardcore nerd. Hardcore nerd if you're gonna pass up getting laid to go fucking play some.
And here's a guy that has no fucking clue what the hell it is. He didn't even know about the bet later on that they had. Because they didn't even make the bet until
I guess to up the ante or something, they or maybe to put some sort of motivation behind the characters, they all decide to up the ante of a C note in the game and put like a wager on it to see who's going to win at the end, which I don't even know how the fuck you win in that.
Whoever gets to the princess first.
If you win in a live action role playing game, you're not really winning in life. There's no winners in that.
No. That's a very small circle of friends that you could brag to.
Oh, yeah. You might win, but you're still a loser.
Exactly.
For three people, you're like, I just won LARP. And they're like, ooh, good job.
Saved the princess.
Did you get anything? No.
bragging rights. I saved the princess.
This is Nick Silly Voice Podcast.
Yes.
But did you win anything?
I saved the princess.
Did you come home with you? No.
I saved the princess, you guys.
That's all it was. So
pretty much.
Yeah.
Hey, you guys, you saved the princess. You're a banana.
Oh, Shakma, you're so wacky and uncoordinated. And
ooh, interesting note.
What?
They spelled this movie Shakma, S-H-A-K-M-A. Uh-huh. However, when the beginning of the movie, you look at the guy writing down the name of the monkeys in the lab, he writes the name S-H-O-C-K-M-A.
Ooh, I didn't notice that.
Yep.
Huh. I remember you saying that they spelled it wrong, but I wasn't paying attention.
They spelled Shakma wrong.
Yeah. Yep. I think I was playing Back to the Future on my iPad.
Do you have that on the iPad?
Yeah, I do.
Let me play.
It's fun, dude.
Fuck this podcast. I want to go play Back to the Future.
I have The Secret Adventures of the Monkey Island, too.
That's relative.
It's Monkey Island.
It's
relative.
The Secret of Monkey Island.
Yeah.
Well, not I said the adventure. Secret Adventures of Monkey Island. God, you are fucking lame.
I'm sorry.
See, now we're arguing about game titles. So, in life, we're really losers anyway.
Yeah.
So.
We really should get back to the important part of this
Monkey
movie,
Island
which
was a fun game, though.
Killing.
Yeah, oh my god.
Oh, there was a lot of death in this.
So, I do have to say, this movie, when it picked up, it really started picking up.
But it picked up, like, in the middle of the movie, and it got to the point where, like, okay, this is the, you know, shit's hitting the fan, this is at the end. Nope, there's still like 40 minutes left.
Yeah.
And that last like 40 minutes just kind of dragged on.
It really was. You're like, yeah, there's 40 minutes. And it's just like 40 minutes where it keeps your attention, and then it just stops. And
what's this
for like 20 minutes.
What's really annoying is all the killings at first were confined to the fourth floor.
Yep.
And so pretty much everyone was safe as long as they're on the fifth floor or third floor.
Leave the building.
Yep.
Yeah. There's a monkey.
But instead of leaving the building, they kept going.
Save that shit for the janitorial crew to clean up.
Yeah, you have fucking Sam who's like, oh, well, we have to find Richard or we have to find, you know, whatever. All the other people. Bradley. Where's Bradley? Where's Richard? Where's the Game Master? Let's go find them. Oh, they're on the fourth floor. Hey, they look dead. But I'm not sure if he's really dead or not.
Let's go back there
after we just got chased out by the monkey. Yep. That sounds like a great idea.
There was a funny thing, I guess the main hero. Well, here, before I even talk about that, I'm going to make this podcast even nerdier and go back and appraise the way the timing of this movie back to a video game.
Oh,
geez. They were LARPing. They decided to go that throughout this movie. It's a climax. Monkey's fucking killing everything. You're really excited. You like the monkey. You're getting amped up. The main guy's going to go kill the monkey. You're like, hell yeah, we're going to get some fucking monkey fight in here. Flash Gordon versus a monkey. I'd fucking watch that. It'd be awesome. But it doesn't happen. So 20 minutes later, he fucking finally ends up in the corner, in a hallway, fighting the monkey. This reminded me a lot of the game Bioshock, where about 75% of the way through, you meet Andrew Ryan, and you're like, fuck yeah, I'm ready to go fucking beat this game. This is going to be awesome. But you still got 8 hours of gameplay left before you finish the fucking game. And by then, you're just like, I'm over it. Let's end it.
That's a very good description of it. Yeah. That's this week.
Yeah. So that was this movie, basically.
It was.
I mean, and then there was something else I was going to say, which I thought was kind of funny. The main character, Flash Gordon, had
It's not fucking Flash Gordon.
It was Flash Gordon. It's not Flash Gordon.
He looked like
Flash Gordon.
No, it wasn't Flash Gordon.
Flash Gordon versus the monkeys is what we watched. The monkey, Flash Gordon versus Shakma. So Flash Gordon was fucking walking down this laboratory. Everyone that died, he decided to grab their bodies and take it to the stairway and just like leave them.
Yeah, he had a weird obsession of picking up everyone's bodies and then randomly throwing them somewhere.
He's like, I gotta go take the body.
He was lining them up in alphabetical order because that's what you do.
Swear to God, there's a scene in this where Chick A is holding the fucking door. Monkey is going batshit crazy trying to get this door open. And Flash Gordon is in the background dragging a fucking body around, and this chick is spazzing out. He can't hold the door. He doesn't give a fuck. He's just dragging the body away.
He went to go, I'll be right with you.
I gotta put this body down.
The corpse was blocking the elevator, so the door wouldn't close. So he went. So he had the chick go and hold the door, so he could go and drag the body and get the elevator from thing. And then he just took it too far. He just kept dragging the body.
Here's the hallway. There's a difference between moving the body away from the elevator and moving it all clear across to the other fucking side of the building.
Yeah, he pretty much did that.
He brought it from the elevator to the stairwell.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then to go along with blocking the elevator, the body started blocking the door and the stairwell.
I will give credit to the Flash Gordon, though.
It's Richard from Blue Lagoon.
It was Flash Gordon.
Oh, fuck.
So, Flash Gordon, he wins the award for most over-dramatic actor, I think, whenever he finds a dead body.
Yeah, he did.
There was literally, there was like a two-minute scene of him just looking around like, oh God, this body. No. I loved her.
He looked at the body with his mouth open, eyes, bursting out of his skull. Then he looked at the floor.
He's dry heaving every single time.
Yeah, think
then
of that.
At the floor.
Think of somebody who's getting ready to puke, and that split second look they have, where their eyes are all big and their mouth is half open,
like they know it's about to happen.
It's the that moment, the face that they're making is etched onto this guy's face for 2 minutes fucking straight. It's just the deaths that he saw, like the bodies weren't that fucking gory that he saw either. It was like,
I don't know, the guy, one guy had,
the
first
only
guy,
the dumbass that grabbed the sulfuric acid that fell on his face,
which was so dumb. Stupid because he grabbed it and you're like, okay, a monkey's about to get fucking burnt. No, No, the monkey attacks him, and the asshole gets the acid on his face.
Yeah,
which this go. Was you're not even aware when he does it. Really, I mean, all you
no, see, you don't see it until later.
Shot that you just don't realize it until you see the corpse later.
Yeah, until you see the corpse later, and there's like some bubbling on him. That's
the monkey must have been very agile to avoid all the splash damage from that sulfuric acid.
There. Yeah, because the cup that the acid was in went straight to the guy's face. Which is exactly where the monkey went. Yeah, the monkey went straight to the fucking face as well. So, yeah.
One thing that I thought was funny also is the guy that got the sulfuric acid burned onto his face. The game master, I guess, the old guy that was running this game for these kids.
Which I guess was the head doctor of the scientist. Yeah.
Head of the department, I guess.
He finds this dead body with a sulfuric acid. So what's he do? He walks up to it, gets right down on it, touches it with his hand.
Both hands.
Yeah, he's like, oh my god. Don't touch the fucking sulfuric acid burned body, man.
Well, I just love how he did it.
Fucking fingerprints.
He didn't just touch it. He touched it just ever so gently with his fingertips.
Yeah.
It was sort of creepy. Then he brought his fingertips up to his chest and left a nice little like pattern of blood drops on his shirt.
It's something a serial killer would
do. And then he just touched his face. He wiped it on his face like he just did the kill himself, and he's like marking that he just got another kill on
him. It's something a serial killer do, or something that some guy would do that's like gone batshit crazy in Vietnam. He's like, I'm going to fucking take this guy's blood and just wipe it all across me.
Yeah.
So I'm a badass.
If Batman would have caught him doing that, he would have got the crap.
Well, this is another kind of fucked up thing. Like, in the event that not everyone was just killed in this movie, and if at least Flash Gordon made it out, there's no way he could have fucking explained this story to the cops.
It
was Flash Gordon. So not only did he burn the monkey alive, so there's no trace of the monkey that went on a fucking rampage here.
Yeah.
He shut off, they shut off all the electricity in the building, so no security cameras captured that shit. He had his fingerprints over fucking everything.
He moved all the bodies.
He's got his DNA splattered all over this fucking building.
Yeah.
And there's no way that you would be able to explain it to the cops. Yeah. You'd be like, a monkey did it.
Yeah, which makes no sense.
Come with me, sir.
Yeah, when it got down to where there was no one alive except for him and the monkey, I would have fucking been out of that building. I'd be like,
well, there's a part where he calls 911 also. He 75 minutes into the movie, he's like, I'm going to call 911.
Everyone is already dead. He finally decides to call fucking 911. And he doesn't say a god. He says something. He mumbles one word that we had to go back and watch it again.
Yeah, I still don't know what the fuck you said.
And like paying attention to it, turning the volume up, we still couldn't figure out what he fucking said.
You play it on here, the thing and see if they can
figure
it out.
This is what he said. Maybe you could, figure it out not looking at it, maybe just listening to it. Soundbite.
Sergeant Patterson of the 911 Police Emergency Unit, can I help you? Is anybody there? Please answer if you can hear me. Hello? Hello? Is anybody there? Hello?
So, there you go.
I know what he said, just to hearing it.
What?
Here we go, soundbite.
He chose poorly.
Yeah, that's right, mister. You chose poorly because you called the cops fucking 67 minutes into the fucking movie to say
dead but
a
me.
Monkey has killed everyone. It's so fucking stupid. He shouldn't. Why didn't he do that on the first body he found?
No. Yeah.
He was like catatonic, and he's like, I better call 911.
Well, I like how partway through the movie he decides to pull a Home Alone and rig up like this. Yeah, he does.
Oh yeah. Well,
to kill the monkey.
What I like, he turned he.
And it didn't work.
Yeah,
at all.
He didn't even use it. Like he pulled out
to go out on the floor.
He pours water over some exposed wires, and then he touches the water. I guess to make sure that it's evenly spread out across the floor. That should be an indication that it's not going to work if you didn't get electrocuted. No, it was already off, and he went over and switched it on.
Did it?
I don't know.
No, all the lights were off because
I call shenanigans on that because I think he really had it off.
Richard turned it off earlier in the movie, and then it showed him going over to it, turning it on, then pulling the wires apart and putting it on the ground.
I digress, but I'm too late. There's no way I'm going back and watching this. Prove it. I'm going to check my notes here and see what else I have. So you guys talk
about
something
relevant. Well, it was sort of interesting because the only actual monkey massacre, if you will, you actually saw was the black guy, the token black guy.
Oh, can I play a game?
Sure.
I want to play a game. All right, here we go. This is going to be the first inaugural edition of a game for our audio listeners. I'm calling it Find the Black Guy. I'm going to play this sound clip. You got to pick out the black guy. Alright?
We at the movie dump don't condone racism at all.
Well, that's why we're playing this. It's not racist at all. It's because it's so... You can't... It's soundbite it.
Come on, Richie.
I don't know, okay?
Come on, you gotta answer, man. Just answer.
Okay, 3.
Wrong.
There are only 2, Richie. You know, I don't give a shit how many little kids play the drummer on the Partridge Family, okay?
That's because you have no sense of culture. What'd you guys do with Sorensen?
Oh, he's telling the class his lip color joke.
His lip color?
Never mind.
So who's this poor fella?
It's Shakma.
Shakma? What did you guys do?
We've injected corticotropin in his brain.
Gross.
No, it's actually quite fascinating. We've been working on a stable variation of corticotropin.
All right, now...
If you chose A... No, I don't know.
If you... Which one do you think was the black guy? Well, put in your votes now, and here we'll play the soundbite of the actual black guy.
We've injected corticotropin in his brain.
Absolutely the one you would not think was the black guy.
Indistinguishable.
The one, yeah, exactly. No black guy there. I would not have expected that to be a black guy.
I've been just quiet the whole time that one went on.
Oh, man. Anyway. Yes. But yeah, well, you know what the black guy reminded me of in this?
Don't say it, Nick. That's racist.
No, it's not racist at all. It's reminded me. He kind of, because he was doing like weird voices throughout the whole thing, he reminded me of that guy that was in the black guy in Police Academy. That
Michael Winslow?
Yeah. But not Michael Winslow.
But not...
Like he was Michael. He just did weird voices, but he didn't do sound effects throughout the entire
So it's like the producers of Shockmire are like, we're gonna have a black guy in here and it has to be Michael Winslow.
We
can't get Michael Winslow. So let's just throw in another black guy and have him making
maybe it was a slightly less talented brother.
I don't know. Carl
Winslow. It was Mark Winslow.
Carl Winslow.
Wait, it wasn't Carl Winslow. No, Carl Winslow was on Family Matters, I think.
Yeah.
So this was Chester Winslow.
Chester Winslow.
So it was really messed up because it was like he was the weird voice guy throughout the movie. He did like the Dr. Frankenstein voice. He did like the Beam Me Up Scotty voice.
He just did a lot of accents. He was supposed to be, I guess, the comic relief.
Yeah.
Which would have been awesome if they actually had him on screen.
He was missing from a good portion of the movie.
The majority of the time besides at the beginning when they're all together, like once the game started, the only time you really saw him was just to remind you that he's still alive.
It was. They're fucking, 20 minutes of the movie, fucking Shakma is going fucking monkey
shit.
That shit
crazy. And then all of a sudden he's just here. Hi, guys.
Hey, guys. I'm down here on level 2.
Still playing the game.
Oh, wow. Fucking Shock was ripping faces off and throwing poo on everything.
I was expecting the end of the game, or at the end of the movie, Shockma's dead. Sam thinks that he's the only one alive. He goes up to the tower to get Kim out of there, and he sees the black guy and Kim just fucking. Just downright dirty fucking right there. Forgot all about the game.
That put the shock in Shockma.
Exactly. Yeah.
You know what I think this game needed? And this would have probably, saved, a lot of time and a lot of deaths. It needed,
mushrooms?
Yeah, super mushrooms. Makes them grow big, then it just stomp on Shockma and soak them up. It needed a safe word. It needed a word that if somebody said it, the game just ended.
To be fair, it's not like they're sitting there like, okay, in case one of our fucking killer monkeys breaks out, we need a safe word. No, we're not fucking around. We gotta stop this game.
I think the safe word should be like,
oh fuck, a monkey's ripping my face off.
Oh, man.
Oh, there was another part that I thought was kind of fucked up, I guess. Flash Gordon is sitting there. There's a part where him and
is it so hard not to just say Sam?
Flash Gordon was sitting there. He and I don't know whatever the main female lead was, whatever her name was. Do you know what it was? Do you have it written down or anything?
I have it here. It is
Tracy.
All right. So Flash Gordon and Tracy are walking down this hallway, and Tracy comes up with this idea to blind the monkey. And
that was a dumb idea.
That was a dumb idea.
We'll do a soundbite of it.
All right.
What is it?
It's a high intensity light strobe. It'll blind him.
Blind him?
Well, temporarily, as long as the batteries last.
So the thing was, like, Flash Gordon like showed remorse towards this monkey that's fucking murdered 4 fucking people already.
Well,
like,
he doesn't know if they're actually murdered yet.
Oh, they're
He just thinks
dead.
That they're injured. Yeah. That's why he dragged...
Hey, you guys, I just want to give you a monkey kiss!
With
that's
me!
That's why he's dragged their lifeless corpse from one point to the other point.
They could be okay.
It's like he has, like...
they can bring him back. This is a laboratory. There's science here.
Like post-traumatic stress syndrome right there.
Maybe, I guess. Yeah,
we'll everything would be all right. We'll be able to finish the game.
We'll just write up all his actions to post-traumatic stress syndrome.
Yeah.
I guess, or something like that.
Well, yeah, you continue with...
I was just stupid, because he shows like, remorse for the monkey. He's like, well, you don't want to blind the monkey. Fuck yeah, I want to blind the monkey.
Yeah,
kill 3
yeah.
of my friends.
Blind, deaf, crippled, we're going for all of this.
Just fucking snap the goddamn monkey's neck.
So he shows
Shoot him!
Not until the end of the movie where he decides, I'm going to burn the fucking monkey alive in a fucking microwave.
Well, it wasn't a microwave.
It was a microwave.
It was
Flash Gordon in a microwave.
Okay.
It was Flash Gordon. Okay. It was not Flash Gordon. Okay.
So anyway, all right, let me look at my notes, see what else I got on here.
I have, there's one note that I wrote down. Cat sounds in the background.
Oh yeah, that was,
oh yeah,
that was hilarious.
Yeah.
There's this scene between
I guess
Richard.
To drive home the fact that they're
in a lab, I guess. But the main thing is a monkey, so why don't they use monkey sounds?
I don't know.
But yeah, here we'll just play the sound bite. This is Richard and Laura having a conversation, and then here sound bite.
So, where are you taking me tonight?
I've got to stay late and help Sorensen.
Richard.
Listen, this is a good chance for me to be around him outside of class.
But you promised.
It won't take long, okay? And, we can go back to your place and discuss maybe primitive mating rituals, maybe?
I've been around these monkeys too long.
Oh, yeah? Have I?
I feel like if we had a random cat just meowing halfway through, like, our that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to adopt a cat for a weekend when we do the podcast. And I'm just going to put him
cat,
on the
like,
table so he's just walking around. And we'll be talking about Citizen Kane. He's like, meow. So the lighting effects, the meow, meow.
What was that? That was the movie dump podcat.
Oh,
I went there.
Oh, yes. Oh. Very good. Yeah, they had a random like cat meowing in the background. Which is fine, I guess, because, you know, there's supposed to be animals in the lab, but why a fucking cat, and why that much? It's gotten to the point where it's, like, distracting almost.
I love, throughout the movie also, just look for the scenes where there's a random monkey in a cage.
Yeah.
There's one, like, chimpanzee just chilling
the
out.
The sole survivor.
In the back. He's like, hey guys, you making a movie? That's cool. I'll just be back here.
The sole survivor of the whole entire fiasco was just some random monkey in a cage.
He was the only witness to
Which, like, apparently every other monkey that was in the cage was attacked by Shakma, but not this one. Apparently this one and Shakma had some sort of arrangement.
That was like his brother. He's like, I'm not going to kill my other monkey friends.
I could see that monkey in
Watch
the
out, Shakma 2, Brother's Revenge.
I could see that other monkey when you know the massacre is going on. Hey man, I didn't see anything.
I don't know what you're talking about, buddy.
It's cool, man.
It's cool.
I'm just over here.
I don't know what your problem is with everybody else, but I saw nothing.
You fling your poo that way, I fling mine that way.
There was a very stupid moment in this also. Well, this is one of many. There was a scene where Flash Gordon needs to...
You're really going to confuse our listeners.
Yeah, well, Flash Gordon needs to bust open a little fire extinguisher thing. So... I don't even remember why he had to bust it open, but there was a fire, like, you know, in case of
I think he was trying to get somebody's attention because he was yelling for.
No, he went to go find an axe, or he was
an
getting axe? Yeah, he was getting something, a weapon.
But he didn't use an axe.
Yeah, he never used it.
That's weird.
Well, that's another stupid moment. But anyway, he needs to break open one of those, like, in case of emergency, break glass things. So he runs.
You mean the ones that have a hammer hanging from them?
Yeah, yeah. So he runs to the kitchen and grabs a mug, runs back, smashes the glass. Why didn't he just fucking use the hammer that was hanging off the edge of it to break the glass?
I don't know.
That was dumb.
I don't know.
I don't know either.
Why didn't he proceed to leave the premise after the first fucking attack? Why are they even in the lab?
You know,
LARPing.
They could have at least say the front door was locked or something, so he couldn't get out. I don't know, something.
All I know is
I would
be
busting
a
fucking window.
This guy could not
open doors. Walking into that building and Monday morning going, holy crap.
Whoa!
There's bodies lined up next to the elevator.
It smells like cooked monkey in here. What the fuck? And hydrochloric acid.
Yeah.
Anyway, this guy... Also, Flash Gordon was really bad at trying to bust down doors because he tried one time at one moment and he's like, ow! Done. Not trying this anymore. Just couldn't open the door. Pussy.
I have another note here about the game master's death scene in the elevator.
All right.
Okay.
Where I guess he finds Richard and he runs back to the elevator. He starts walking back to the elevator, and right when he gets into the elevator, he sees the monkey on the end of the hall looking at him.
It's just like, hey.
Yeah, it's just one of those, like, the monkey just standing there like, oh,
hi, you like elevators too? I love elevators. I want to ride the elevator with you.
It was just something about that scene.
Elevators?
Faces!
Something about that scene was just so funny because it was like the look on the monkey. He just jumps up on his back legs and starts running towards him.
This monkey did have a really lot of, you know, just awesome looks. I guess the best actor in this movie to the monkey.
He had, like, you know, it was funny because this monkey was so not intimidating. It was probably the size of a backpack, you know?
Yeah.
And, like,
it was a tiny monkey.
You know, if you were in an elevator, hallway, maybe, you know, 40-foot hallway, elevator opens, and you see a backpack-sized monkey at the other end, you're not going to be all that scared. You're going to be like, look at the monkey.
But
if it was a fucking Congo gorilla, you know, like silverback thing, you'd be like, oh, fuck, that's a big monkey. Yep. He could fuck me up.
Okay.
This is a little tiny thing.
Yeah, yeah. But throw in
teeth.
And probably the moment, the split second before the monkey lunges at your throat, though, is where you're like, uh-oh.
This monkey has 4-inch razor sharp fangs.
Throw in the fact that you just discovered a dead body with bite marks all over it. And
I probably would.
And there's the monkey, like, down the end of the hall.
I wouldn't even put two and two together there. I would have been like, holy shit, I gotta save this monkey from whatever killed everything.
I would have gotten in that elevator and fucking left. I wouldn't even, you know, taken time to stare at the monkey and be like, oh, so
cute. Well, I would have been like, man, go up to the fourth floor, fight the killer monkey, go outside and call the police at a payphone. Huh?
I guess I'm just a wuss that way. If I'm like, oh, fuck this.
No, you're like every other being on the fucking planet.
I can
like,
see
fuck
the,
this shit.
I can see
here.
The police trying to interrogate, you know, the survivor.
Yeah.
Like, so
it
what
just
made
seemed...
you decide to go back up to the fourth floor and do this by yourself?
There was a monkey.
I don't know.
I had to kill the monkey.
Vengeance.
Don't you think it might have been a better idea to go outside and call us? We have guns. There's many of us.
I know why. I know why he went up there.
What?
He chose poorly.
another thing that was kind of funny, I think, was I forgot what I was gonna say. I had something
very nice, very
that
nice,
was hilarious.
Right, my
way,
head.
So.
Oh yeah, they shut off. They went to the fuse box and they shut off all the electricity in the fucking place except for the elevators.
But they did shut off the
they
fire
shut
alarms.
Off the fire alarms. That's safe.
Yeah, why the fuck would you shut off the fire alarms?
I don't know.
In case a fire...
In case you're LARPing and you just go fucking batshit crazy and call the fire department?
Magic missile know. Fire alarm.
Yeah, right.
Uh-oh! Like, oh, God damn it, you ruined the game by pulling the fire alarm.
Yeah.
That's stupid.
God.
Yeah, I didn't even... Yeah, I didn't... And, wait...
But I saved the princess!
If they turned off all the power, If they turn off all the power in that building, or at least
I thought
on
it was
that
selective. I thought
on
it was
those
like,
floors,
it had
or whatever.
To been selective.
Yeah, it had to have been on at least those floors that they were on. There were still some computers that were
there. Yeah,
being
there were some
used.
Computers around.
Yeah, yeah.
And
the monkey
and the elevator.
Computer.
Was, and you know, for it not having any power, there was a lot of light.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Yeah. I think that's because there was a light factory next door, maybe, and they had all the lights turned on.
No.
That's what I'm going with.
Okay, a light factory next door.
Yeah.
Why not?
There was a huge inferno next door. there was an interesting movie going on next door. So
they were right next to an outdoor theater's movie screen, and the ambient light was coming in from the screen and lighting up most of the building, just totally killing the ambience, by the way.
Set design sucked in this movie,
oh,
also, by
yes.
the way.
Well, there I mean, it's a lab. It's a big fucking building.
It's accurate.
There
know,
was very little lab equipment,
boring.
I think.
Yeah, it was very accurate.
I didn't see one test tube in there.
That's
I mean, there was
Shakma broke all of them.
Yeah, Shakma. Yeah,
there was.
He didn't
test
go fucking crazy.
There was
he
a scene where Shakma just
shit.
Yeah, Shakma just goes fucking nuts and just destroys a lab, throwing beakers and fucking expensive. He destroys a computer for some reason.
He just
like,
does
whoa.
It because he's fucking Shakma. He can do it.
90, so you know, a computer, you know, portable computers that size cost like $100,000 a piece.
And thank God, I really hope they had monkey warranties on it.
Yeah,
seriously. Uh-oh, what happened to your computer? Monkey went ape shit on it.
Well, we
Apple
Care
will not
I'm
cover
sorry.
This.
We don't cover monkey damage.
Yeah. The monkey goes batshit crazy, kills everyone. I think probably the
bad decisions.
Yeah, I think the coolest death in there would have to go to what was her Teresa was it or.
Oh, the
Tracy.
In the bathroom?
Tracy. That was probably the best shot death scene.
Well, it was kind of funny because you don't see her dying. You see, she's in a bathroom stall hiding from the monkey. Stupid, because the monkey. Just,
well, she's trying to
monkey,
climb up. Yeah, she's trying to climb up through the through the air vent.
Well, stupid anyway, because she's in a bathroom stall trying to escape from this monkey. It's not a gorilla. It's a fucking backpack-sized monkey. So the monkey's just like, hey, I'm just going to go right underneath the bottom of it.
And
fuck you up, bitch.
And they did this shot where, you know, it's down on the ground, so you see the bottom of the stall. You see the monkey standing there, and you don't see you don't see Tracy. And then all of a sudden, the monkey just jumps up. And then you just hear
lady, I really like your shoes. Let me hug your face.
You just hear all the commotion and all this blood-curdling yells. And then Tracy
and then
like
it
just
goes,
pops
it,
up.
Well, no, it's maybe a minute of thrashing and scary-sounding noises, dead silence.
Yep.
So you're like, oh, maybe the monkey and Tracy's dead. Then you see Tracy come up. And then the monkey fucking comes back again.
Yeah, it's that little spot of like, whoa, wait, how did she survive this? Did she just like knock the fucking monkey out? Is he tired of all the carnage? He decided to take
the
a little monkey nap.
The monkey was toying with her. You
like,
know
yeah.
what
yeah.
He fucked her up. Then he's just sad. He's like, hold on, I gotta pee. And then he ran out of the corner and took a piss. And then he's like, now's my chance to get away. He's like, oh, I'm back. Let's go play again.
You know, the scene really, it kind of reminded me of the one scene in Jurassic Park where the hunter gets attacked by the velociraptor, where he's sitting there perching, ready to try to attack. He sees the one, and then the other one pops out.
Yeah,
and that whole like death scene is like done from behind the bushes, and you hear the sound. You know what's going on, but you don't see it, and it still makes that visual.
Yeah,
that's what this does. Like you know what's going on. You've already seen it enough during the movie, and you just have that visual of what's happening.
Yep. Yeah,
it's just like oh, tiny monkey is mauling someone.
Yeah. One thing I learned about this is obviously velociraptors are more intelligent than a fucking monkey because velociraptors can open a fucking door, whereas this monkey could
not. All doors, though.
Not all. These are round.
Yeah. The round knobs they cannot open.
All right, well, velociraptor cannot.
And the monkey did open the round knobs. He was sitting there pulling on them, and he worked the elevator. He pressed the button for it to go to the fifth floor.
I really want to go to the fifth floor now. I think they got bananas there.
Oh.
So do you want to take that back?
No.
Okay. It was Flash Gordon?
It was Flash Gordon.
Okay.
It was a Shakma monkey.
Oh, man. Because,
I don't think I have any more notes.
No, I don't have. I mean, that's pretty much. We covered it. It's a fucking monkey that goes batshit crazy, bangs his head against the doors, and kills every single person in there.
You know what I think really sort of made this movie not good?
What?
It was because the monkey was so small.
Yeah.
That was a big part of it. And I could just see, you know, the director, you know, he's got this script, he's got this all lined up, and he's ordered this huge monkey from, you know, like this, from this animal trade. He's like, this is going to be great. And
oh my God, that monkey looks so scary.
The monkey's like 2 feet tall. He's like, well, what the?
Wait a minute, that was a lot bigger in the picture. What the fuck?
Well, apparently, like,
did you read the fine print? Monkey Man would actually be actual size shown in the
It's like going to McDonald's. You see a fucking Big Mac, you're like, that looks huge, and you order it, and it's just a little tiny, little shrinky thing. You're like, oh.
Well, apparently, looking at, you know, trying to do a little bit of research on this damn film, it's not an actual, I didn't know this, but like Shakma is an actual type of baboon, which is a little larger of a baboon, apparently,
than what this one.
So it wasn't even a Shakma baboon. I don't know how big regular baboons get. I guess they could get pretty fucking big.
That would sort of make sense because the name Shakma really doesn't, I mean, match anything going on in this movie.
No.
So I guess, you know, if they were planning on having an actual Shakma baboon, it would make sense. But yeah, they got Tiny Monkey 2000.
So. Yeah.
Like Tiny Monkey 2000. This is an upgrade from our earlier Tiny Monkey model, the
Tiny Monkey 64.
You know?
64. With new 3D monkey graphics.
Oh, now a 64-bit processor.
Yes. Anything else?
There was a really, really nerdy Steve Jobsy type guy that was the first death in this.
Thank the majorly. Fucking God. That guy, he was like,
I think if anybody is a LARPer, he was the closest example to a LARPer. Yep.
And he was really very, he was the IT guy at your work that is kind of, you know,
he's kind of creepy.
And you feel like he would probably be stalking you outside your bedroom window. And has a shrine of
he
you.
He takes so much joy in every sentence he has in this LARP.
Yeah, it's like every sentence that he says is almost an orgasm.
I'm going to save the princess.
Well,
wait, here, soundbite.
I've got the clue, and I'm going to try. Wait a second. I think I just heard Nemesis. I'm going into the specimen room. Over.
Bradley, where did you say you were going? Over.
The specimen room. I think Nemesis is hiding inside. Can't pass up the chance to receive eternal life. Over.
Guys, I like monkeys. I don't
know. It was very he was like the creepy, like, I'm really glad he died soon.
Yeah, he was the first one to go, because even the jock was kind of tolerable, but this guy was just kind of, it was creepy. He was creeping me out.
Well, I don't know, was he cheating at this game, maybe? Do you think?
Well, he walked in
because he was like the first one to the game master guy like made the comment of like, oh, this is going to be a very fast game. He's almost at the end already.
Well, no, he was making the comment because Richard Nemesis wasn't doing what he was supposed to do. Yeah. Apparently, if you run into Nemesis, you get sent back or something. I don't know what the fuck. There's some sort of consequence, but he just sat in there and did nothing.
I don't know. If they explained the fucking game more, you'd figure it out, I suppose. But
yeah. I mean,
not on this
one. Just have that knowledge from, you know, all those many, many years of LARPing.
LARPing, yeah.
Right. Ben, did you save the princess?
I saved the princess.
Well, guess what? You're still a fucking loser.
Oh.
What did you get?
Respect?
Oh. Respect from all my other LARPer friends who couldn't save the princess.
I got this really nifty blue Nerf sword.
I dual wield with my battle axe of ogre slaying and my
monocle of doom. I don't know.
Monocle of doom.
Laser monocle.
Yeah.
My monocle 64. I hope we upgrade to monocle 2000 later on.
All right. Well, do you guys want to get into the final reviews?
Sure.
Yeah, sure.
Let's do it. Nick, you go first.
It was a monkey movie. This is a movie that I don't think anybody's going to see. Nobody's going to find. It wasn't even hard for us to find this movie, I think.
It was really
nobody's hard. Really going to go out and watch it. If you do, you gotta watch this like with a bunch of like frat buddy friends, I think, almost. And you gotta have some beer involved, and you gotta have somebody that can do a voice of a monkey whenever that shows up on
yes.
the scene, because it's way more funny. You know, you can really make a lot of fun of this movie, I think, for the most part. I mean, it's a monkey movie. They're LARPing. Everybody looks really fucking stupid. It's cheesy 80s clothing, bad set design, stupid ideas. I mean, the action mostly consisted of a monkey slamming its head against a door to get to somebody on the other side. That's a good 40, 50, 60 minutes of it. And then the last, you know, 30 minutes of it, there's nothing going on. But it can be a fun movie if you're with the right crowd. Overall, the movie was pretty bad. I mean, I could watch it again if I had a bunch of friends like hanging out and just if we were looking for something to make fun of. This would be a great movie to do a riff track to, I think.
Oh, hell yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I think we might have to do that to a couple scenes.
Maybe. Yeah, maybe. I don't know. That's,
I don't know. If we're, that's if we're not quite lazy. Our thing,
but,
if we're not lazy enough.
Yeah.
Lazy but talented.
Lazy yes. but talented. Yes, lazy but talented.
Can you do that? Hell yeah. Well, will you demonstrate it for us now?
I think out of all the movies we watched, like in this sitting, it was I think this was one of the more enjoyable movies I've watched because we were able to make so much fun of it. So that raised the value of it for me up to like a 4, I think. But this movie, all in a nutshell, is like really a 7 or an 8, probably. I go with the 7.
Yeah.
I think my firm. Well, so here I'll equate the two together since. With a bunch of friends, it was good. It was like a 4. Alone, it'd be like an 8. So that'll even it out to a 6, I think, in my book.
All right. Sounds good.
Okay.
Yeah, so what do you think of it, guys? What? Banana!
I give this movie a banana. No, I actually agree with Nick here. It's one of those movies that if I was watching it by myself, I wouldn't have made it. It was...
It'd be quick to change the channel.
Yeah, I mean, there's about a million other things you should probably watch besides Shakma. It's not like when you think monkey movie, most of the time people can't think comedy, not, you know, like evil monkey stalking and killing people. Yeah. And that's what this movie was. It was very
you
obscure.
Definitely don't think LARPing.
Yeah, you definitely don't think LARPing. But anyway, this movie is definitely more fun if you make stupid voices for it. In fact, it sort of encourages you making stupid voices for just the amount of times that the monkey's down at the end of the hallway
yeah.
and runs straight at the camera.
And he's got
you
such a stupid
it.
Expression
you
on his face.
You can't help
half the
it.
Time.
You're just like, "Oh, baboon!" But nope. So this movie was really stupid. I'm going to sort of follow, you know, Nick's philosophy on this. Due to the fact that, you know, watching it with friends, making fun of the movie the entire time, I'd say it's probably like a 5, you know, 5, 6, something like that, with friends making fun of it. Watching it by yourself, taking it for what it is, it's like an 8. It's bad. I don't like it. So I'll put it together. I'll say it's a 7. Yeah, we'll say 7. 6.57, somewhere near.
I zoned out on both of you guys. So
just agree with us. So you're going to say the exact same thing we
probably.
Just did, probably.
I give this movie a banana.
I like feces.
I
give this movie strawberry.
I give it purple.
3 blueberries and a panda baby.
Orange and grape.
Grape soda's delicious.
Can I give it my review?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. Yeah. I'm just going to say right off the top, it's an 8. It's an 8 for me.
Just crap.
It was just crap. I mean... It was fun to watch it, and the only reason why is because of you guys, and that was it. It was an 8. Nothing.
There's not much redeeming.
There's
value
nothing.
In this.
There's no redeeming. I mean, it's a cute monkey.
It's a well-groomed monkey.
It's a very.
It wasn't a cute monkey. This is a baboon.
It's a
baboons are not cute. They have like red asses.
It's a well-groomed monkey. It's a monkey that looks silly when it's running. It banged his head against it.
Every time it runs at you.
That's like the only. Yeah, that's the only redeeming value for me is it thrashing violently against the doors.
Yeah.
For some reason, that was just it was just hilarious to me. So yeah, 8. I give it an 8.
Okay.
All so right. 8.
I give it 6. I think
6.
7.
7. Okay. 6. 8. 7. 8.
Yeah.
All right. So that's good. So 13.
Yeah. So what are we watching next week?
Oh, it's my pick.
All right.
I have a whole slew of monkey movies. I'm still trying to figure out which ones I want to do.
Yeah, see, that is the thing with monkeys. It's just like there's there are so a ton many. Of monkey movies.
All right. I have Monkey Trouble.
Oh.
Ed.
Oh. I can't watch that. It rhymes too much with Fred. That movie just sucked.
I was thinking Congo.
All right.
Interesting.
And then the big stretch, which I guess would fall along the lines of like Indiana Jones and Kingdom of Crystal Skulls, would be...
Spymate?
No, Tim Burton's Planet of the Apes.
Well, obviously, since Ben can't decide, please email us and let us know if there's anything you would prefer for us to review.
There are a lot of monkey movies out there.
Yes. Youthroughpoo@me.com. Very appropriate for Monkey Month.
Yeah, it is.
Month of Monkey involves poo.
Yeah.
Check out our website, themoviedump.com.
Yes, that's where you can find our links to every other networking site that we have out there.
Yep.
Yes, and yeah.
First go through it 1,000 times, you know.
Yeah, we're not going to even, we don't need to list off any of the other things. You just need to know the www.themoviedump.com.
For all your movie dumping needs.
Yes, and email, as Nick said, youthroughpoo@me.com. So until next week, I'm Ben.
I am Nick, and don't forget to get your monkey spayed or neutered.
Oh. And I'm Shakma.
yeah, I like it. Shakma, like Shakma.
Yeah.
Yes.
I know. It was tricky that way.
Yes. And enjoy your week.
See ya. Now I'm the king of the swingers. Oh, the jungle VIP. I've reached the top and had to stop, and that's what's bothering me. I want to be a man cub, and stroll right into town and be just like the other men. I'm tired of walking around. Oh, ooby-doo, I want to be like you. I want to walk like you, talk like you. You'll see it's true. An ape like me can learn to be human too.